And the other parts will be also utilized for the agriculture production activities effectively. And another very interesting discussion is that along the coast, we could build the artificial dam, but it's not the dam to really protect the tsunami, but it's minimize the impact of tsunami. And on the top, we could use the soils and then plant the trees. And this is on the daily basis could be utilized as a scenic beauty or the, for the recreation. And on the and at the case of the emergency, this could be utilized for minimizing or at least decreasing of the natural disaster. So this is another trial that we are now trying to develop. Another example is that at the Ministry of the Environment, we are discussing about the possibility of establishing a new type of a national park. And this national park is tentatively called Sandvik Rebuilding National Park. And what we are trying to do is that this national park will be a showcase for the combination of the Satoyama and the Satomi, as I already explained. And one of the examples is that near the area that is called the Kesenuma Bay. We have the national park, very existing national park along the coast. And then we have the prefecture national park, nature park, behind this national park. And if we could try to combine as a bigger national park, and then we could include the mountainous areas, and then the agricultural land, and then the coastal areas. And one of the very famous fishermen whose name is Mr. Hatakeyama, he's a fisherman and he is doing the oyster farming, but on the other side, he is establishing NPO and encouraging the local people move to the mountain to try to plant the trees on the mountain because there is some sort of the nutrition cycles between the two. This is an example of how we could combine the Satoyama and the Satomi. And also, we also could consider this area to be a sort of the geopark. Geopark is designated by the UNESCO, and we could use this geopark to memorize the disasters and so on. And there are many possibilities of renewable energy, not on this national park, but along the central part of the mountains, there are many possibilities of developing the geothermal energy, as Dr. Tepfer explained. And I had a chance to visit our institute in Iceland, where they are trying to coordinate the nature conservation with the development of geothermal energy. And this March, the government, particularly the Ministry of the Environment, tried to modify their internal rule, and so that to some extent we could use the geothermal energy even in the national park. And so this is a very good development. But of course, we must be very careful how we could coordinate the two aspects, the nature conservation and the use of energy. And I'm proposing the necessity of the strategic environmental assessment for the four potential areas throughout Japan, particularly the Hokkaido and the Tohoku, and also the Kyushu areas. And for example, the Fukushima case, I think that because of the nuclear accident, development of the geothermal energy is quite symbolic for their near future policy. And also within the establishment of the new national park, we are including the several projects, including the Satoyama Satomi Eco Museum, and also the long distance nature trail from Aomori Prefecture to the Fukushima Prefecture and so on. So this nature trail, by the way, could be utilized on a daily basis for the tourism or the recreation, but for the case of the emergency, then this nature trail could be utilized for the evacuation route. And so this is a sort of a way of combining the daily basis resilience and the emergency basis resilience. You could notice that the resilience concept could be identified into three categories. One is a specified resilience against disaster, against the tsunami. And then the second is a general resilience. So the society itself is resilience against unexpected disaster or the change in the environment. And then the third one is transformability, how we could move forward toward the increasing or the strengthening of the resilience. So these three concepts of resilience could be fully implemented in our trial for the contribution of the rebuilding of affected areas. So this is my conclusion. We should think about that the disaster rebuilding process could be an opportunity toward the establishment of a sustainable society. Particularly, I emphasize the importance of the establishment of the society in harmony with nature. And this could be a new type of green economy. So green economy, many people are talking the different way, but what I would like to emphasize is we must think more about the real green. It is biodiversity. So while keeping of the biodiversity and ecosystem services, and on the other side, we try to develop the way of sustainable economic growth, including the establishment of a new business model and the establishment of a new commons. And this, once we could establish this type of idea, that we could use this idea to the other part of Japan and also to the other part of the world, including the both the developed countries and developing countries. This is what I emphasize, the importance of establishing the biodiversity-based green economy concept when I was in Rio plus 20 last month. So I would like to conclude my speech that now it's a challenge how we could really using our bioresources and biological and ecological services, as well as the natural capital in our society. We unfortunately neglected the importance of this aspect. I'm very looking forward to working together with the other colleagues on this aspect toward the sustainable society. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Takeuchi, for your organized the presentation and the remarks, and you have also covered the many instructive the points, including the new challenges of new commons, new business model, as well as the rebuilding the efforts, namely the Sanriku, the rebuilding parks. And these are very much the encouraging to us to recover, rebuild, as well as to move forward in the future in a positive manner. That is the very important message. At the same time, Professor Takeuchi, I welcome the new three definitions of the resilience. That is also the we wish to the further develop the under your instruction again. Thank you very much, dear Professor Takeuchi. Now, let me invite next speaker, Ms. Tomoko Nishimoto. She is the Director, Division of Regional Cooperation of the UNEP. Her background is also introduced in the program, and you can take a look. And she has a lot of rich experience with UN systems, including UNDP as well as UNICEF. Now, she is going to talk about the resilience and the natural disasters in the context of Asia and the Pacific. Now, Ms. Tomoko Nishimoto, please.